So there are several strategies that are on our minds. How to switch? Should I abruptly stop or start? Should I abruptly start the new, titrate the old? Start the new slowly, titrate down slowly? I mean, there's so many variations. But we have to consider what would be the optimal approach to prevent tolerability issues and to preserve efficacy as best we can. In order to do that, we have to understand the pharmacodynamic profile, that is, which receptors do these drugs hit? And we have to also understand the pharmacokinetic profile, half-life. And keep in mind, no matter how carefully you design a switching strategy, patients will do what they like. And they may stop their old medicine abruptly because my doctor is switching my medicine. I just want to stop it. I'll just stop it. And they do. And they won't necessarily tell you either. And they may not even tell you about their side effects that they're experiencing either. You have to really have a conversation about this and try to make sure that they know that you're not doing this arbitrarily and you're not recommending this to them arbitrarily, but you want to minimize the chance of rebound phenomena, rebound side effects and tolerability issues. You don't want them to complain of poor sleep all of a sudden, or GI distress all of a sudden, or feeling out of sorts all of a sudden, or having abnormal movements all of a sudden. We're gonna do first steps, get a good baseline assessment, cognitive assessment, make sure you got all your ducks in a row in terms of all your labs, and then we'll use the dose of the current medication to target the dose for the new medication. If they need high doses of stuff, they may need high doses of the new stuff. I mean, that's like common sense. And there are many strategies. There are more strategies than yoga positions. So I wouldn't pay too much attention to this long list. I would just go over three basic strategies. Abrupt discontinuation? Well, it's simple, easy to understand, easy for us to write, but you may have symptom exacerbation and possible withdrawal reactions. So you run the risk of someone all of a sudden having more symptoms and then withdrawing from the prior drug and having side effects there, and you don't do it. So don't do this if you don't have to. You may have to with clozapine, and patients may end up doing this, but don't do this if you don't have to. Cross-tapering sounds attractive until you reach that point where you're not on enough of anything, and then you possibly will get breakthrough psychosis. So I don't do this either unless I'm pretty confident that they were on too high a dose anyway. Delayed withdrawal, I think, is my favorite here because I don't want to have a relapse of symptoms. I really don't. And I tell patients that we're going to do it the safe way. I'm going to start your new medicine now and keep the old as much as I can. And then once you're on the right dose, the dose that you're going to be on the new drug, we'll start decreasing the old medicine. Lots of patients like this, but I warn them, you might get some more side effects during that time when you're on maybe too much of the antipsychotic. So I warn them, and don't do this. Who remembers this robot? Yeah, danger, Will Robinson. Don't do this. Avoid stopping the old drug. Okay, you're on nothing now. Let's, gradually start up your new drug. That's just too dangerous. You're going to end up with an acutely exacerbated patient too often.